this is the first Monday that I say to the Archbishop about this proclamation as your Archbishop. Archbishop Dan Tapu has come a long way since I first knew him as a coordinator in the past proclamation here in Cebu. Back then, Father Dan Tapu was a preparative young priest, always recommending things to do for the seminary, for the people in the parishes where he has been assigned, for the classes he was assigned as assistant to the economists. When the apostolic council asked us, beside bishops, for names to be proposed as bishops, we included this name along with more senior and more experienced members of the clergy. To our surprise, it was his name that the Holy Father chose to be considered Bishop of Cebu. Archbishop Dandu still remembers what I told him when we first talked after the announcement. I told him, Pate Pustapa. Down in my heart, however, I knew the Holy Spirit knows better. Father John Booth, the assuming priest whose name is phonetically identical with John Booth of Evergreen, Sr. The name, unadated by a hypothetical man whose presence at the time, Sr. would shed light on what really happened. It's precisely that example. Father John was an assuming as anyone could get, doing his work quietly, leading his priesthood as faithfully as he could, serving God's people with zeal and devotion. This example, the hypothetical man, was lifted from the anonymity by the Lord to become the shepherd of his God, because he lived his priesthood with real commitment, not just a superficial, deluded form of adherence based on service consideration. It is possible, after all, to be a shepherd, but not a committed one, only someone who acts like a hired man. For Father John, priesthood was not the way to climb the social ladder, but a path to social transformation. He did not leave this priesthood enjoying its perks. Even as a bishop, he still drove his own car from the location of Cebu and back. In his first parish assignment as a bishop, he personally accompanied the auroras in the Cebu City's red light district. He did not transfer. Which was part of Santa Rosario Parish, and this has not was nothing extraordinary profession of him. For him, priesthood was meant to be lived by laying down one's life, not making a name for oneself. So for some people, being gentle, being anonymous is unbearable. But for Father John and David Bishop John, being gentle is part of his life. Long before he became Father John, he was always a cantinero in the seminary. The cantinero is the most anonymous role in the seminary. The cantinero is in charge of the cantine. But unlike any cantinero, who simply opens the cantine, serves food and closes it at the end of the day, seminary John transformed the cantine into a successful cooperative, thereby showing in his seminary life. When one is truly trustworthy in little things, he will be entrusted with greater responsibilities. Do you read that? That is a principle from the Lord himself. Today, Archbishop John Silver said that him, a restaurant happened in the city compound in collaboration with the Secretary of War, but more than a canteen or a restaurant, he handles the finances of the Catholic Conference of the Philippines. It is not an enviable job. Considering how we have money, that is CBCT has. But what we done is about the piece of John to at the helm, to finance the stability of the party line. This is why the success of John brings the tax dollars to the local. You need diligence, pastoral solicitude for both people and the clergy, and yes, financial atonement. People and clergy paro, what more can you ask of God? Over and above these qualities, there is something more than you, my faithful religious clergy paro, can have at all. It is the kind of faith your Archbishop has. His genius in financial planning is matched only by his faith in God. He does not take adverse risks in financial matters. I can assure you that he was after all my economist for many, many years. But whatever risk he did not take in the field of the finance, he would become reckless in matters of faith. This is my advice to you, parish priests. Be reckless. Be reckless in diving into all kinds of apostolate. Do not be too concerned about your welfare. Give yourselves fully and totally, and the people will also give themselves with equal restlessness. Do not worry about where to get your funds, your kinds of apostolic endeavors. God, who desires what you do, will supply everything that you need. So I was weary with bishops who drive their own cars. They can speak up so that everyone will have a pass out. Archbishop John does not know how to slow down. You, my dear clergy and people of the Lord, you will have to take care of him by first giving a good driver. Then perhaps he will slow down. In truth, Archbishop John is God used to you. He is a workaholic, but that's only because he is a good shepherd. Like a good shepherd, he listens a lot. He got the training as rector and spiritual pastor from his university. He does not listen endlessly. He also acts decisively. And so, may you also listen to him and act with him for the common good of the Metropolitan Association of Palu and for the greater glory of God. Amen.
Please stand. you'll now press our faith to be one God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all that sins and sin. Believe one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, and the God of the Father, God of God, life from life, true God from true God, the God of the name, one who believes the Father, who will always serve me, for as man is God of our salvation, came down from heaven, that the power of the Holy Spirit was born of our today, became man for our sake. Was crucified under the Pontius Pilate. He suffered and died and was buried. The third day rose again, fulfilled the scriptures, ascended to heaven, and seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come again to glory, judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. And the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken to the prophets, we believe in one holy family of apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. God is gracious. He is our awesome Father. He is our wonderful Savior. He always takes care of us. He leads and accompanies us in our endeavors and undertakings through His Spirit. Today, as a sheepfold gathered together with His pastors, let us pray for Him our prayers and supplications.
For every intention, we pray together and say, Good Shepherd, listen to your people.
That our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, our bishops and leaders of spiritual communities throughout the country, the bishops, priests, and deacons, the entire believing were in the church through their inspiring life and unselfish ministry, let us pray to the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
loving and caring for us.
Your Holy Spirit, assure us in every segment of the journey. Assure us once more that what we ask you today is great.